Desiring God says there are two types of risk. The foolish kind, which are forbidden and often spoken of in the Bible, versus Christ-honoring risks, which have their own eternal reward. These are the kind we see modeled by the Apostle Paul, the prophet Daniel, and Queen Esther. Small risk for Christ, small reward. Great risk for Christ, great reward. Charles Haddon Spurgeon, the prince of preachers, once said, "They who navigate little streams and shallow creeks know but little of the God of the tempests. But they who do business in great waters, these see his wonders in the deep." What Christ-honoring risks are you willing to take this week at work?
For more about I Work For Him and our vision to transform the workplace of every Christian into a mission field, go to iworkforhim.com. That's I Work, the number 4.
Today is July 15, 2020. This is your News to This Hour. I'm Gail Agadia for FABC Radio. For the local news, the city government of Mandaue has belied rumors that it will be implementing a city-wide or barangay-wide lockdown amid the rising cases of COVID-19 in the city. The city's public information office clarified that only households or groups of households that have COVID-19 cases will be under lockdown and not the entire barangay. The city government assured the public that stay-at-home kits containing relief goods and vitamin supplements will still be provided for households that are under strict home quarantine because of confirmed COVID-19 cases. In other news, the government has laid out strict rules for suspected and confirmed COVID-19 patients opting for home quarantine. It says those who have space limitations should stay in isolation centers. Deputy Chief Implementer Against COVID-19 Vince Dizon has said, a patient should have a separate room and toilet for his or her exclusive use and must not have senior citizens, pregnant women, and those with pre-existing medical conditions living in the same house. On the other hand, a new program called Oplan Kalinga, which will be rolled out, will allow authorities to fetch patients from their homes to be brought to isolation centers in coordination with the local health units. And that's the news to this hour. This is Gail Agadia for FABC Radio. Check your time. It's 7:02. Good morning.
This is FABC Philippines, communicating Christ in our world for 73 years. Now, on air and online. 1116 EXAS, San Juan La City. 1162 EXKI. Coronado City, 103.3 The New J, Cagayan de Oro City, 1197 DXFE, Davao City, 106.3 DZRK, Quezon, Palawan, 1233 DYBS, Buffalo City. Up 987 DYFR, Cebu City. 97.5 DYFE, Tacloban City. 1143 DCMR, San Diego City. Care 104.3 The Way at Hand, Legazpi City. 98.7 DZFE, Metro Manila. 702 DZAS, Metro Manila. And online 24/7, Now XD and Pinoy Connection.
Up 987 DYFR-FM, life changing. Good morning, Gail here. I hope you're safe and well this Wednesday morning, even amidst the pandemic we're facing. But hey, there is hope, so don't lose heart. God is with us and He promised to never leave us behind. So cheer up, hang in there, and take encouragement from the songs and inspiration that we're giving you today. Start your day with the song Happiness by Need to Breathe. It describes the feeling of learning to move on and forgiving yourself.
It's all for you in my pursuit of happiness.
Good morning to our friends who are watching through YouTube. I hope you're doing well today. I want to say hi to my family who's also watching, Talia family in ATCP. Hi, Zildjian Paul. I hope you're doing well.
Inspiring, life-changing.
As for flowing streams, so my soul longs for you. You are faithful, God. You've shown me mercy. At your feet, I will worship. You are faithful, God. As the deep, as for flowing streams, so my soul.
Enjoy the Sunday afternoon. You're dismissed.
Wasn't that a great sermon?
Yeah, come on, let's go.
No, there's the Johnsons. Let's see how they're doing.
No, 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 no.
let's go.
Why? Are we doing something this afternoon?
I just want to hear a sermon and go home. If we hang around here too long, then somebody might ask us to do something.
Is that so bad?
I don't want to spend all day at church. I came, I listened, I sang. Now come on, let's go.
Dear, we are part of this body of believers. We should be doing something.
Can't we be a part of the body, but not a functioning part of the body?
You mean like dandruff?
Yeah, no.
Look, I just want to ask John if he found a job yet.
John's out of work?
Yeah, the last 4 months. He told me at the men's breakfast last week.
How's Sarah taking it?
I'm not sure.
Oh, I should talk to her.
I thought we just wanted to go home.
How can you think of bolting out of here when people need to be encouraged?
I didn't.
Sometimes you just don't think.
Me?
Oh, shush.
Another message from Lifeline Productions, the comic strip of radio, and lifelinepro.com.
Like
what the power of God's love can do in your life? So it's up, man, ain't it?
Playing now is a new track from North Point Worship featuring Seth Condre, Oh, What a Miracle, which talks about the miracle God has done in our life. This is Up 987.
Thank you.
life-changing, communicating Christ on air, online, and on the ground.
Almost every event of any importance is a side benefit of something else. If you're searching for happiness, for instance, you're not going to have it. But if you're doing something else, sometimes happiness comes along. The problem with most Christians is that we work too hard, suffer too much, obsess too often on being good. In fact, the reason we're so bad is that we're trying so hard to be good. Obedience isn't something to work hard at and achieve. Why? Because almost everything of any importance is a side benefit of something else. Goodness is a side benefit of being loved and loving God. And almost always surprise. I'm Steve Brown. You think about it. Share what you just heard with a friend. Go to youthinkaboutthat.com.
How do we implement social distancing? Avoid crowds and large gatherings. Maintain at least 1 meter distance from the next person, particularly individuals with cough or cold or respiratory disease. Make it a habit to wash your hands with soap and water. Or alcohol-based hand sanitizer. A reminder for the BCOO, VOH-ADP.
Always keep those safety health reminders, especially that the virus is still very here. Our time is now 7:31 a.m. This is UP 987, life-changing FM station, a Far East Broadcasting Company, Philippines. I want to give a shout out to my family listening today, to my papa, mama, brother Aiden, sister-in-law Ayin, nephew Z, sister Chai and her kitties, Drinky Daff Daff, Safe Cotton, and Mushi. I hope you guys are well. And I also want to say hi to my best friend, Gabby Flores and Richard. I hope you guys are well also. Thank you for letting us accompany you this part of the day. And I hope you're able to pick up insights helpful as you cope with this health crisis. The past 4 months have been tough for all. We're all struggling in different ways. My family and I have struggles too. We're not exempted. But one of the things that keep us going is being reminded of who God is and taking Him for His word. Probably if you find yourself super struggling right now, probably it will help if you list down some characteristics of God or what He has done in your life during this quarantine season. Sometimes, or not really sometimes, most of the time, if we're going through tough times, our eyes tend to focus on things that we don't have. Our eyes tend to focus on our problems, the trials we face. How about we do the opposite? How about we start counting our blessings and naming them one by one? Do that today. Make that your challenge for today. Coming up next is Tori Kelly featuring the Hamiltones for the song Help Us to Love. Let this be our goal too, especially this season, especially with what we read on social media. Help us to love, Lord.
There's a love so high
that you cannot
get over. That same love. Love died somewhere behind the cross you went. You're afraid when you look at me.
is calm and all is right. When I feel your favor flood my life, even in the good I'll follow you. Even in the good I'll follow you. When the boat is tossed upon the waves, and I wonder if you keep me safe. Even in the storms I'll follow you. Even in the storms I follow you.
That warm the heart.
Yes, this is Up 987, a life changing. You're now hearing Jeremy Camp for the song I Still Believe. A movie was released based on Jeremy Camp's story, so check it out.
I still believe. Thank you. Emmanuel, station manager of UP987 DYFR-FM Cebu. Friends, in the last few weeks, we've shared with you the funding challenges facing the station, and we've been incredibly thankful for your outpouring of support and all of your prayers. And as we continue to find ways to sustain the broadcast during this difficult time, we've made the hard decision to reduce our transmitting power by 30% effective May 25, Monday. This arrangement will allow us to work with the modest resources that we have and to preserve the round-the-clock 24-hour broadcast that we began delivering to you last August, which is a milestone and a priority for UP987. Now, reception may deteriorate in some areas because of the low power. If you experience this, we urge you to listen via the mobile app FEBCPH or to request a link to our online stream. Above all, if UP987 has encouraged, inspired, or has been a companion to you, we invite you to join us in bearing up the station, both in prayer and with your giving. The operations of UP987 depend entirely on your donations. Faithful giving of any amount will help us bring our uplifting music and message of life change to those who so deeply need it. Please check our pinned post on Facebook for more information and feel free to reach us with your questions.
In case you haven't heard yet, we have lowered our transmission power by 30%. So if reception in your area deteriorates, we encourage you to tune in online. We have a mobile app called FEBCPH Stream, which you can download on App Store for free. And you can also listen through your web browser. Just message us for our streaming link. Our time is now 7:53 a.m. Happy Wednesday. I'm Gail for UP987 Life Changing. Member of KBP, Kapisanan ng mga broadcasted ng Pilipinas. Hi to you, Sir Fred Pardorla. And I also do the Dalisay Scouts on the 28th Memorial Day of Chief Engineer Romeo Villar Pardorla. I hope you guys are doing well amid the pandemic we're facing. And by the way, to those who have been sending us text messages, for some reasons, we can't receive them, and we can't even receive calls sometimes. So if there's a message, especially important messages you want to send us, it's safer to send it through our inbox or messenger on Facebook. So again, if you've been sending text messages or if you've been trying to contact us through our mobile number, we're still figuring out what's wrong. But if there's something urgent, something important that you want to relay with us, the safest way to do so is through Facebook, through sending us a private message, all right? Thank you so much for understanding. Now, one great habit to practice day by day is gratefulness. So what is one thing you're thankful to God for? Think about that today and thank God for that. It really does make a difference in our day when we are thankful.
Yeah. Proverbs chapter 15, verse 12, mockers resent correction, so they avoid the wise. The Bible is clear. One of the signs of the last days is that people will become childish regarding the promises of God. They will mock and ridicule God. Mockers use this tactic to avoid the truth God's word brings. Mimicry and making fun of the characteristics and mannerisms of people who are passionate about the truth is childish behavior. The Bible warns, first of all, know without any doubt that mockers will come in the last days with their mocking, following after their own human desires. Remember, don't laugh with the mockers. To learn more, go to BibleStarMan.com.
Today is July 15, 2020. This is your News to This Hour. I'm Gayla Gadia for FEBC Radio. For the local news, the Mandaue City government has urged frontliners and senior citizens to receive an influenza or flu vaccine and a pneumonia immunization. Although the Mandaue City Office or MCHO administers these vaccines every year, the number of people getting vaccinated has gone up since the start of COVID-19 pandemic. MCHO head nurse Thelma Suico said employees of the city government started coming in last week to get their vaccine shots. Although the flu and pneumonia vaccines won't protect the public from COVID-19, Ms. Suico says at least people will get protection from these two common diseases. In other news, the country representative of the World Health Organization in the Philippines has said it is still early to tell if the outbreak of the COVID-19 in the country has already reached its peak. To date, the Philippines has so far confirmed over 57,000 COVID-19 cases, including 20,371 recoveries and 1,599 deaths. Dr. Rabindra Abiyangasinghe said the government should exhaust all efforts to ensure the implementation of a comprehensive response against the pandemic so that the country can reduce the number of people getting infected. Meanwhile, the WHO official has urged the public to remain compliant with health protocols as the country opens up the economy. And that's the news to this hour. This is Gayla Gadia for FEBC Radio. Check your time. It's now 8:03. Good morning.
This is Far East Broadcasting Company Philippines, celebrating 72 years of communicating Christ in our world, on air and online. 1116 DXAS Zamboanga City, 1162 DXAI Coronado City, 103.3 The New J Cagayan de Oro City, 1197 DXFE Davao City, 106.3 DZRK Quezon Palawan, 1233 DYDX Bacolod City, UP 987 DYFR Cebu City, 97.5 DYFE Tacloban City, 1143 DZMR Santiago City, K104.3 Domay FM Legazpi City, 98.7 DZFE Metro Manila, and 702 DZAS Mega Manila. Your message is Christ, our hope, our life. You are God.
Encouraging. Inspiring. You just gotta leave. UP987.
Yes, this is UP987 DYFR-FM, life-changing, broadcasting live from Emmanuel Bible College compound, Banawat Hills, Cebu City. Gail here, joining you till 9 this beautiful Wednesday morning. Have you heard? Three Japanese nationals living in Barangay Apas here in Cebu City are using their vacant time doing something productive as the city continues to be under ECQ due to COVID-19. So they are actually using the quarantine time to clean up neighborhood in Cebu City. We're so thankful for this act by these foreigners, and that's a challenge for us Filipinos, locals here in the city, to also show that kind of initiative. It makes me throw this question: how have we been using our quarantine time? May that put things in perspective. Coming up next are songs from Stars Go Dim and Tugma.
Can't wrap my mind around where you see me not go. Stand in my mess and call out the best in me. When my mind gets crowded with the lies that I'm told, you tell me the truth and show me that you believe in me. You believe in me. You know me as honest. You know me as good. You know me the way that I wish I could. Ooh.
States that everyone has sinned. Have you thought about your need for forgiveness, or are you focusing on the sins of others? Another message from Lifeline Productions, the comic strip of radio, and lifelinepro.com.
This is the song.
Live of God.
UP987 DYFR-FM, life-changing. Broadcasting from Emmanuel Bible College compound, Banawakil, Cebu City.
Please keep your locking Bible with Pastor Colin Smith.
Spiritual mourning is always over particular sins. Most of us experience times when we feel a general sense of our own failure, but that's not spiritual mourning. Mourning over sin in general never moves you forward, it just leaves you feeling miserable. But spiritual mourning has a clear focus. It is mourning over particular sins that you've come to see through the ministry of God's Word as God's Spirit shines a light on it. When you begin to see your own sins, state them clearly, without excuse and without evasion. I have acted out of envy. I have insisted on my own way. I have deceived and I have covered up. This is a sin against God. Take your sins out of the dark place. Come into the light.
This material is based on Pastor Paul's book, Momentum. Order your copy at UP987
Watch. Stay connected with others and important social groups, even in the midst of social distancing. Use phone, video, or online tools to check on each other and share emotional support. Practice compassion by assisting those who need the most support in this crisis. Offer to buy basic needs for persons living alone, the elderly, or the disabled. Remember, majority of people who contract COVID-19 will recover. Scientists and experts are currently working to find a cure and vaccine for it. There is help from government and non-government and private sectors. Basta laging handa at sama-sama sa kanyang lakas, kaya natin to. A message from the Psychological Association of the Philippines and FEBC Philippines.
Our time is now 8:31 a.m. Hey there, this is UP987, life-changing, specially designed to give you a boost as you tune in. So may the songs and inspiration bring comfort and encouragement as we continue to find ways on how to live with COVID-19 around. Speaking of COVID-19, we are expecting announcements from the government within the day as to what quarantine level we will be in starting tomorrow. Well, cases are not becoming better here, but the economy has been badly hurt as well. So let's pray for wisdom for our government officials as they continue to evaluate, as they continue to assess our situation. With that, listen to this song by Casting Crowns called God of All My Days. A song which I would describe in Cebuano as dulit sa heart. I hope this song speaks to you and pushes you to surrender to God.
Came to you with my heart in pieces and found a God with healing in his hands. I look to you, drowning in my questions, and found a God who holds all the wisdom. And I trusted you, stepped out on the ocean. You caught my hand among the waves, 'cause you're the God of all my days. Each step I take,
you're the reason.
life-changing. Up 987 DYFR-FM.
Do you feel the world is broken? Do you feel the shadows deepen? Do you know that all the dark will stop the light from getting through? Do you wish that you could see it all made new? Is all creation
yeah.
DYFR-FM. Life changing. Communicating Christ on air, online, and on the ground.
Keep children safe and ensure their security. Speak to them calmly. Supervise their use of social media and the shows that they watch. Educate them about parts of the body that others must not see or touch. Consult your local barangay council for the protection of children or call CWC Banday Bata 163 or Red Cross 143. A reminder from the council for the wealth.
Our time is now 8:51 a.m. You're on UP 987, life-changing, 98.7 on your radio dial. There's a trending Filipino movie on Netflix right now. I'm sure a lot of you watched this already. The movie is called Through Night and Day. It's about an engaged couple taking a once-in-a-lifetime trip to Iceland where they find their relationship tested in unforeseen ways. Yes, there were portions that I ugly cried, but I won't further discuss what I think of the movie as a whole. What I want to share with you is one reminder that I got from the movie, and it's this. For a relationship to work, you really have to die to self. You know, as humans, it's natural for us to think of ourselves first. Ako sa. No, how can it benefit me? But doing so is a relationship destroyer. Being in a relationship involves dying to self, especially in marriage, especially when you become parents. And my husband and I are learning that as newlyweds. Now, what does dying to self mean? It means putting someone's interests above yours, looking past beyond the person's imperfections and failures. You know, in a world that is competing for who loves more than who, this is the secret. Dying to self is crucial, and Jesus did it for us. So I pray that He will enable us to do it so our relationships would thrive. Remember that always. We want to greet happy birthday to Apple Joy Saleta. God bless you more. That's from Tito Dumano. And happy birthday to the rest of our friends who are also celebrating their birthdays today. May you have an awesome birthday celebration even amidst this quarantine season. We have another local track, Akala Ko'y Wala Nang Pag-asa by Yan Asuncion. We are not without hope. Where there is Christ, there is always hope. My name is Gail. Remember that you are blessed for your loved, so have faith.
Amen.